you just joined us on the System After Dark, this is a homegrown number, courtesy of E3 and Cracker.
Bulla, how's it going? I'm D, your host on the System After Dark, right here on Today FM. Today is hit music. You can catch me weeknights at 7 p.m. That's from Monday to Friday, only on the home of Today's Hit Music. And don't forget, that's D with you every weeknight on the System After Dark.
Good evening, this is FBC News. I'm Jackie Spate in this bulletin. Prime Minister Borenge Bainimarama announces Fiji's bid for place on UN Human Rights Council. New state-of-the-art facilities launched at CWM Hospital. And customers urged to report burst water pipes to help curb water wastage. Prime Minister Borenge Bainimarama is lobbying the United Nations for a more Pacific presence, announcing Fiji will bid for a place on the Human Rights Council as well as the presidency of the next UN General Assembly. Bainimarama also championed climate change, calling for a legally binding agreement and fully funded grant financing in Paris at the Conference of Parties. Maggie Boyle reports.
I have great pleasure in welcoming the Prime
Minister. Addressing the United Nations General Assembly, the Prime Minister announced Fiji's bid to sit on the Human Rights Council as a unique voice representative of Pacific small island developing states.
Attention to the detrimental effect that climate change is having on our ability to extend and strengthen human rights in the region. It also includes educating others to the challenges many of us face in creating proper institutions and changing long-held cultural attitudes that can be obstacles to full respect for human rights.
The PM was clear on what the climate change agenda should be.
The Suva Declaration calls for the 2015 climate change agreement to limit global average temperature increases to less than 1.5 degrees centigrade above pre-industrialized levels. It calls for the Paris Agreement to be legally binding on all parties and for it to recognize loss and damage as a standalone element. We also call for the climate change adaptation measures to be 100% grant financed.
Bainimarama also highlighted Fiji's work on Sustainable Development Goal 14 on the conservation and sustainable management of oceans and seas. Earlier this week, this was transformed into the triennial UN conferences on oceans and seas. Reiterating the need for the Pacific to have more presence where it counts at the UN, Bainimarama put Fiji's hand up to be Assembly President.
And we have put forward a candidate for the Assembly's 71st session. Our candidate, duly submitted to the Asia-Pacific Group, is currently Fiji's permanent representative to the United Nations, Ambassador Peter Thompson. He is a seasoned diplomat who has demonstrated extraordinary leadership in service to the United Nations.
Bainimarama also used the platform to elaborate on Fiji's progress a year since the elections, talking about the raucous parliamentary exchanges as the price Fijians pay for the many blessings of democracy. Maggie Boyle, FBC News.
CWM Hospital in Suva now has state-of-the-art surgical theatres, intensive care unit, a burns unit and some of the newest medical equipment around. Health Minister Chone Osumathe launched the facilities today, saying this is all in preparation for additional demand on the health sector. Edwin Nund has the details.
Well, with these scissors, I cut this ribbon to commission this new operation here.
These new facilities that cost more than $11 million are set to meet the demands of patients for the next 20 years.
One of the two operating theatres we open today is designed according to international standards, specifically for neurosurgical operations. The second is specifically designed for orthopedic operations. The 25-bed intensive care unit has also been designed and equipped to international standards.
Hospitals conduct 10,000 surgeries every year, with close to 6,000 of these done at CWM Hospital alone. Minister Chone Osumathe says for medical service providers, things will get tougher.
The demand for health services is also rising. as our population increases and becomes more educated and knowledgeable, their expectations for health services also rise, and rightly so.
The ministry has spent about $46 million on hospital upgrades and new equipment. CWM's facilities will elevate patient care, providing highly advanced surgical, orthopedic, and neurosurgical procedures.
Health services in Fiji need to advance and to be modernized to keep abreast with development and technological advancement in all areas of medicine and health services.
Highly trained surgeons and physicians from Fiji and abroad can now perform life-saving procedures in some of the best facilities in the region. Edwin Nand, FBC News.
The Water Authority of Fiji is urging customers to report any burst pipes in their homes or in their neighborhood. WAF General Manager Customer Services Sekove Uluinayao says when the burst pipes are left unattended, it not only requires a lot more repair work, but a lot of water is wasted. Shireen Lata reports.
Over the years, the Water Authority of Fiji has spent a great deal of money, time and effort in fixing burst water pipes.
It's a major concern, eh? Because we're losing out on millions of dollars in investment in this infrastructure.
Uluinayao says apart from spending millions of dollars in repairs, thousands of liters of water have been wasted.
So that's why we're working towards improving this age-old infrastructure to, in order to better serve the communities by supplying clean access drinking water to them.
While the authority is trying its best to address this issue, they are also urging customers to do their part.
To foster that relationship with the public where they can report the leaks they find along the road, or so we can come in and fix it quickly.
Water Authority customers are urged to attend the roadshows held around the country and share their views on how WEF can provide better services. Shireen Lata, FBC News.
The Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions charged 5 people with rape in 11 separate incidents last month. There were 4 victims, of whom 2 were under the age of 18. Of these 2, one was a 12-year-old and the other a 13-year-old. 2 cases were discontinued before the courts after discontinuance were filed. Meanwhile, the Fiji Women's Crisis Center, while welcoming the release of the statistics, has asked for further analysis of why some cases are discontinued. Coordinator Shamima Ali also says there is a need to further strengthen reporting of such cases and the whole legal process. The first phase of the Lenga Lenga housing project in Nandi has been completed and was visited today by the Minister for Housing, Pravin Bala. The project is expected to be complete by the end of the year with 200 lots ready for the market. Madhyambola Itamana reports.
A little over 3 months since the groundbreaking ceremony for this housing site, and the first phase of the project is well into full steam.
And I'm very happy to say the progress of the works. It's only 3 months after the groundbreaking, and about 70% of the works in phase one has been completed. So I'm really happy, and I think weather is very favorable, and that's why the contractor has managed to carry out works in such a short period of time.
Housing Authority has confirmed receiving over 2,000 applications for the 200 lots that will be made available at the end of the first phase of the project later this year. The minister says they will be closely scrutinizing applications before making offers to those applicants.
We will make sure that those who are given lots are those people who do not own any lots or any house. I want to make it very clear. And then there will also be a ceiling in terms of salary. So these are some of the policies that we are working on. And by end of December, I can tell you now that we will start selling lots here in phase one.
Phase two of the project is expected to commence by the end of this month, while the Tavakumu project in Lotoka is also expected to start in December. Madhyambola Itamana, FBC News.
Still to come, Fiji to raise fuel standards.
Gold FM, only the classic hits. Beautiful song from the group Firehouse and When I Look Into Your Eyes. Before that, you heard from Smokey Robinson with One Heartbeat. We'll take a short break and join us in the next hour for more music from Seal. Bulabanaga. I'm DJ Tora. Join me every weekdays, 7 until midnight, on the Premium Classics, right here on Gold FM, only the classic hits.
Digicel Fiji has confirmed its plans for Sky Pacific are on hold at the moment. Chief Executive Darren McLean confirms any operational changes to Sky Pacific, including improvements to programming, are waiting final approval from the Minister of Communications before they can be implemented. Communications Minister Ayo Said Kayum last night put out a statement that his ministry is still yet to issue a pay TV broadcast license to Digicel Fiji. A decision is expected in due course. Fiji will soon raise the standard of fuel it uses. Minister for Trade Fayaz Khoya says government is in the process of moving into a higher fuel standard, most probably Euro 4 or Euro 5. Speaking at the launching of the 2016 new Ford Ranger XLT last night, Khoya says the new vehicle is an indication of the progress of the motor vehicle industry in Fiji. He says the high-efficiency vehicle augurs well with the government's initiative to encourage more fuel-efficient vehicles that will contribute towards reducing fuel consumption.
And the newer model vehicles also require better quality fuel. Therefore, to move with improving vehicle technology and to reduce vehicle emissions, the Fijian government is currently in the process of evolving itself into moving to another, a higher fuel standard, which may be Euro 4 or Euro 5.
Euro 4, Euro 5 will set the average carbon emission target for all vehicles that will run on Fiji roads. The Indian High Commission celebrated its Technical and Economic Cooperation Day last night. ITEC is the Indian government's flagship program for capacity building initiatives around the world. Under the program, hundreds of Fijians have been able to receive scholarships to study in India. Acting Prime Minister Ayo Said Kayum says India has been an important development partner.
And we're carrying out a review of the public service and indeed a restructuring of some of the key ministries within the service. And it is therefore critical to ensure that we have a cadre of people who are not just the right and well-qualified people, but continue to have the training that's required, what I call on-job training and upskilling.
110 Fijians have been sent to India under the ITEC program in the last 12 months. Westpac Bank and the Ministry of Women have signed a memorandum of agreement to help women in the country. The agreement will, amongst things, support 600 women who will be attending the National Women's Expo next month. Shriti Prasad has more.
The contribution to the economy of small and medium enterprises run by women is gaining a lot of support. Westpac Bank yesterday signed an agreement with the Ministry for Women that will support business women.
Westpac supports gender equality in the workplace and the elevation of women in the community. Indeed, we understand one of the Millennium Goals is to promote gender equality and to improve the ratio of literate women to men. Everybody has an important role to play in this objective.
Minister for Women Rosie Akbar acknowledged the assistance from the bank.
We are very, very grateful and very appreciative for Westpac's past history to support, empower and connect local women to markets to enhance their economic capabilities and create opportunities for improved livelihood. The partnership that the ministry has with Westpac provides a strategic way forward for the empowerment of our rural women in micro-entrepreneurship and business development opportunities.
The bank also contributed $50,000 for the National Women's Expo next month. The Women's Expo is to be held in Suva from Wednesday, October 14th to the 16th. Shriti Prasad, FBC News.
October is devoted to raising awareness about breast cancer, usually referred to as Pinktober. Hosting a Pinktober breakfast at the Mai Suva Park in Asese Suva this morning, Assistant Health Minister Veena Bhatnagar says thousands of women who've been diagnosed with cancer are honoured this month. Breast cancer survivor Marianne Wong Lee says fighting for 11 years hasn't been easy. However, she likes to stay positive all the time. Lee says other women who are also fighting should come out and share their story. Sports is up next. Here's Jamie with the latest.
Nakataki, and good evening in sports. After the break, Flying Fijians ready to settle score with Wales tomorrow morning, and Rajesh Patel confident of retaining his Fiji FA presidency. Details coming up.
छू 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 हे हे नमस्ते फिजी, आपके हर एक प्रॉब्लम की दवा लेकर मैं आ गई हूँ 9 से 12 बजे तक आपकी सहेली रेनू। छू 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 40 में 20 का दिखना है। मैं हूँ ना आपके साथ में मिर्ची एफएम पर 9 से 12 बजे तक मंडे टू फ्राइडे। मिर्ची इट्स हॉट।
The stage is set for the crucial Rugby World Cup match between the Vodafone Flying Fijians and host Wales tomorrow in Cardiff, with Wales coming off an upset victory over England and Fiji still hungry for its first win at the World Cup. The match is lining up to be another epic battle between the Wales and Fijians. Inder Singh with this report from Wales.
The reports and updates of the Rugby World Cup is proudly presented by Vodafone, Power to You, and Airports Fiji Limited, creating new experiences, Fiji's gateway to the world. In association with FMF, the right choice. Total Exelium New Generation, the fuel that cleans your engine kilometer after kilometer. Sun Insurance, for Fijians, by Fijians. Supported by Fiji Airways, Deluxe, Island Chill, Comfort Home Furnishing, Rooster Chicken, Legal Aid, Land Transport Authority, and Central.
The Flying Fijians having a feel of the pitch at the Millennium Stadium for the second time in a week before the big clash, with one rep more eager than perhaps others.
Last game because of the citation, but that's done, and I'm looking forward to this week's game.
The former skipper knows the chance to end the winless streak at the World Cup dating back to the second game in 2011 is there, but it will be a tough ask.
Yeah, we know there's a couple of injuries for the Welsh team, but still playing one of the Tier 1 nation in World Rugby. So, yeah, we're still going to prepare for anything that's going to happen tomorrow.
The Brains Trust have been working hard to ensure they deliver tomorrow, and amongst that, trying a few tricks of their own.
The reason is rugby, I think, is such a great game, and that's why so many people are interested in the Rugby World Cup, because it is an unpredictable game.
It's going to be a massive crowd to support the Dragons in Cardiff, and nothing but pure pride and passion will lay the platform for a Fijian win. 10 times Fiji and Wales have played each other, and Fiji has only managed one win, and that was in 2007 at the Rugby World Cup. Can they make it 2 at this event and this edition? Will be known tomorrow. But one thing's for sure, these Fijians are hurting, and they want a victory at the 2015 Rugby World Cup. At this very stadium, what an achievement that will be. Interesting, FBC Sports.
Now, as the Flying Fijians gear up to face Wales tomorrow, Coach John McKee says the side will be at a benefit to have more top-level matches. Asked on whether Fiji should be included in tournaments such as the Rugby Championships, McKee said this would improve Fijian rugby, but there were logistics that needed to be taken into consideration. Inder Singh reports.
Despite not having bagged a win in the World Cup so far, the Flying Fijians have shown potential to mix it with the big guns.
Oh, certainly. I think, you know, we've got to work, you know, the Fiji Rugby Union and World Rugby and probably with SANZAR to explore possibilities going forward. I think definitely would benefit Fiji to be involved in more high-level test matches.
The Fiji Rugby Union has over the years cried out for more Tier 1 teams to play the national side, and this is something which is continuing.
There's a lot of things that need to be put in place for anything like that to happen, but certainly, you know, Fiji Rugby Union, you know, working closely with World Rugby on the test match programming and you know, planning for the next 4-year cycle is very important.
Argentina's admission into the Rugby Championships has seen the Pumas grow in leaps and bounds, and if given a chance, Fiji could follow suit.
And as you mentioned, I mean, Argentina playing in the Rugby Championship, although it's been hard for them to get results. I think it's really improved their play.
After all, the Fijians have shown that with proper guidance and the best players, they are on the right track.
Oh, look, we would love to be involved in a competition like that, but you know, there's a lot of economic factors involved as well. You know, it's really quite another story outside this Rugby World Cup, and it's as I said, you know, the World Rugby and Fiji Rugby are working on various strategies going forward, and in the very short term I can't see that happening, but I would hope that in the medium to long term we can achieve something along those lines.
So with two more games to go, hopes are that Tier 1 nations for once don't only look at each other but help teams like Fiji in the spirit of the game. Indra Singh, FBC Sports.
Meanwhile, Fijian number 8 Netani Tale says skipper Akapu Singera is one of the best captains Fiji has ever had. Tale, who will play along Guerra in the back row against Wales, says it's been a great achievement for Guerra to reach his 50th cap and at the same time skipper the team.
You know, he's passionate about what he does on the field, and you know, he's a good leader, and the boys, he leads the team really well, and you know, it's just unfortunate for us for the last two games, but you know, we're coming in this weekend with everything we've got, and you know, with Q leading us, everyone's ready to go.
The Flying Fijians take on Wales at 3:45 a.m. tomorrow, and you can watch that game live on FBC TV. Fiji Football Association President Rajesh Patel is not threatened by the upcoming FA elections. He says the current presidency has done a lot for the sport in the country, and it's the decision of the people that matters.
People are wise. It's not money can buy everything. It's sometimes, you know, when you have throw a lot of money like these people are trying to throw in, you'll have people that is not interested in football just to get hold of money into the organization and come in and try and run it. And after 6 months, they're totally gone.
Meanwhile, the Fiji FA has received all nominations for the president and vice president's elections scheduled for next Tuesday. And finally, this evening, we'll leave you with a video of the Vodafone Flying Fijians singing a few of their favorite gospel numbers. Hope you'll enjoy.
Airways new Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer Andre Filion has officially started work today. Filion told staff that he is excited about the journey ahead. He says the airline has done well so far in 2015 and encouraged employees to keep this up in the last quarter of the year. Filion joins Fiji Airways after its recent transformation, including its rebranding from Air Pacific and a fleet upgrade, and at a stage when it is exploring further commercial opportunities, including new routes. He has 33 years of professional experience in the airline and tourism industries. Filion was previously CEO of Air Mauritius. I isolated showers were experienced over the eastern parts and interior of the larger islands. Afternoon cloudy periods prevailed elsewhere. A weak trough of low pressure with associated cloud and showers remained slow moving over Tokelau and Tuvalu. Another weak trough of low pressure lies slow moving east of Vanuatu. High temperatures were experienced throughout the country. Suva recorded 28 degrees, Nandi 29, Lautoka, Ba and Lambasa were the highest at 31 degrees, and Sabo Sabo was the lowest at 27 degrees. Forecast for tomorrow's cloudy periods with few showers expected over the group. Outlook for Saturday, expect much of the same. And the main points again, Prime Minister Vorenge Mbainimarama has announced that Fiji will bid for a place on the Human Rights Council as well as the presidency of the next UN General Assembly. CWM Hospital in Suva now has state-of-the-art surgical theatres, intensive care unit, a burns unit and some of the newest medical equipment around, and the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions charged 5 people with rape in 11 separate incidents last month. Visit our FBC website to take part in our poll question for this week. We were asking, are there enough litter bins around in public? Remember, you can send us newsworthy pictures and videos on email citizenseyes@fbc.com.fj or share it with us via Facebook page, FBC News. And if you're on Twitter, follow and tweet us your news tips at @FBC_news or simply #FBC News. You've been watching FBC News. I'm Jackie Spate. Bye for now.